Hi, everybody. I'm Albert, your host for this virtual meeting with Jayaprakash, who is in Agile community. We often call him as JP. He would be talking with us about a leadership coaching. It's a hands-on workshop that is going to happen in Regional Scrum Gathering India at Hyderabad. Okay. And also he is going to share us with some coachability assessment tips also during the workshop. Okay. So JP is a Marshall Goldsmith Certified Executive Coach, SEEC, and a leader in modern software engineering. Specializes in coaching executive one-on-one setup as well as coaching for organization transformation needs in agile, lean, and DevOps areas. JP is well-recognized speaker in many Agile conferences, including Business Agility Institute, Lean Kanban, Agile Global Event, Discuss Agile, and many others. Coaching leaders is an art and a science. While attempting to coach leaders, it is very important to assess the coachability aspect of the leader before proceeding. Come, let's discuss about it with JP about leadership coaching and coachability assessment tips. Hi, JP.
Hi. Hi, Albert.
Hi. So, JP, just to brief about yourself, can you tell about yourself, what you do and how is your day goes?
Yeah. So, Albert, I think since you introduced me already on my credentials and the kind of experience I have, so let me give a little different introduction. So I think nowadays I'm trying to discover myself. What am I trying to do and how am I working with organization and the leaders, especially in the coaching context? And the more and more I'm getting deeper into this work, I'm realizing that I'm probably trying to help people reduce the suffering in the transformation.
Yeah, that is true. That is more important for us.
Right, especially for leaders, because if someone wants to transform or lead the transformation at the organization level very seriously, you know, all of us in the Agile community are aware that it's not an easy journey. Now, it is also not just about Agile. Any sort of transformation for the leaders, it's a painful process because it demands a lot of personal transformation. So I'm trying to probably equip myself, and also more and more experience I'm getting, I'm trying to help and work with leaders, be empathetic with them, and then trying to help them, sail through the journey with less pain.
Okay.
If I were to put it that way.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. And yeah, it is needed for every leader to reduce that pain so that they can focus on things that are more important. Yes. So your topic, your workshop is on the leadership coaching and a live demo with coachability assessment tips. Can you tell us more about it, sir?
Yep. Yeah, so I think, you know, this is an interesting topic, not only for me. I'm definitely passionate about it, but also many of the people that I interact with, whether it's fellow coaches or the leaders who are driving the organizational transformation, they come to me a lot of times on, you know, does any leader wants really coaching, right? Or if someone wants, can we really coach some leaders? And do they really even accept coaching? Would they really make use of it? And a lot of these questions, right? And also in my own experience, whether it's coaching a normal person or a leader, of course, in various other forums, I've talked about the coaching as a concept, right? The day we realize, the coaches or the to-be coaches, we realize that while attempting to coach, it's not really about myself as a coach. It's not really about even fixing the person that you're trying to coach, because there is nothing to fix. It's all about enabling the person to realize certain aspects, certain context, which is driving himself or herself and driving the behaviors, right? The context. So once you make it visible, it becomes easier for a person, the coachee, right, to take informed decisions about how he or she would like to proceed in their journey and hopefully find some solutions for their opportunities. So in this context, most of the people struggle on how do we get started with coaching leaders, right? And also that's also crucial for coaching any leader. So in this live hands-on workshop, I'm attempting to demonstrate how do we help leaders. First of all, even before we try to help, we would like to validate whether they need help, right? Whether they want coaching. In other words, whether they want to achieve something in their life, want to progress in their leadership career, in their transformation journey, and are they ready for a personal transformational journey, right? That's more about assessing the coachability aspect. Yeah. And then once we do that, how do we help them? What are the areas that matter to them? The growth areas, right? It's not really about, you know, problems. You know, who doesn't have problems? Everyone has problems. But those problems, as long as we are able to help leaders to relate them to their potential growth areas, and if you spin it around, how do you want to be in this growth journey? And how can you achieve this with your stakeholders, right? Every leader will have a certain set of stakeholders.
Yes.
Once we help them connect their growth opportunities and the stakeholders, they will be in a journey. And as a coach, you can just intervene based on the need. So this is what I'm intending to demonstrate.
So this workshop is not just about agile. This is about, it can be personal, it can be career, it can be anything.
Yeah, in fact, this is nothing to do with agile per se. I mean, of course, very relevant for agile transformation leaders. But even if you're not trying the so-called agile transformation, but every transformation has to be agile in nature if you really go by the meaning of being agile. But nevertheless, without attaching the regular connotation about agile, Scrum, any person, any leader who is leading a change initiative, which requires not only the personal transformation, but also the org level transformation. Such leaders need support, right? Mainly because, you know, they are executives who are super busy and plagued with so many dynamic, complex issues from the organization. How can we give them that space where they can experiment? So it is irrespective of agile, I would say.
Okay. So that brings me into one question on, the leaders, as leaders, they take crucial decisions every day in, day out in their organization, career, and all the stuff. Do they really need a coaching per se? Is all the leaders need coaching?
Right. So this is a question which needs to be answered by every leader. But if you ask me personally, my experience, both putting myself as a leader, I'm also an entrepreneur, so I've been leading many initiatives for my own organization. I'm also entrepreneurial in nature when I work in the org level agile transformation, for example. So I'm both an entrepreneur in some cases and also a coach. And sometimes I separate them. I wear different hats. If you ask me about my own experience as a leader, do I need coaching? In fact, even if I'm a coach, do I need a coach? Yes, a coach needs a coaching support. A leader also needs a coaching support, primarily because, not because we are bad at something, right?
Okay.
In fact, this thing would work only for successful leaders, right? Successful entrepreneurs, successful coaches do need coaching, because when you are behind the successful journey, it so happens that some little tiny behaviors of us would be blocking us from performing at the next level, which we may not be able to notice because we are in this, you know, rat race of being successful.
Okay.
Sometimes, you know, along with that, we're also plagued by certain transformational concerns and, let's say, systemic impediments, which will block our thinking, right? Hence, you know, it would be worthwhile to consider a coach, and is very much relevant in the area of sports or any of those individual personalities. If you're seeing, every successful athlete will have a coach. Every successful CEO will have a coach, if you really notice. Not because they are bad at something, because they need someone with whom they can bounce their experiences, their aspirations. And during that experience sharing, they can witness where they are blocked, and so that they can proceed.
So So in this, if I can tell the audience, so this is like the coach is like a blind spotter, where the leader is blocked in some places where he can enable the leader to go forward. Would that be a right connotation?
Yeah. So we're almost right there. Just a small, minor modification. I may not be able to spot the blind spots of a leader, but I would help the person get access to his blind spot.
Okay.
Right. That means the person has to witness, person has to go through the journey, okay. has to take the pain of, you know, figuring it out and then, you know, taking actions in a very disciplined manner. In fact, this is a right question which will bring, remind us to remind the audience, the participants who are going to be in our conference to know three important aspects of a leadership coaching journey, right? Yeah. That's called, you know, courage, humility, and discipline, right? You know, any leader who wants to be coached, who wants to grow in certain area, first of all, needs to have a courage to, you know, go into areas which are not so comfortable, going beyond their comfort zone to try a few new things, and also keeping it open with their stakeholders, right? Sharing with the stakeholders about their journey, involving them in their journey, seeking feedback, and also something called feed forward suggestions from the stakeholders, which is not going to be easy. So they require courage. And also when you get some feedback, you need to have the humility to acknowledge without trying to judge about okay. other people's feedback. Just receive the feedback as feedback and see what is useful and work on it. And basically close the loop back by validating again with your stakeholders.
Okay.
And then any leadership transformation, personal transformation, if it has to stick for a long time in a sustainable manner, it requires very disciplined approach of taking actions regularly and also involving stakeholders regularly. So if these three aspects can be followed, then your journey would be much more effective.
So is also a part of coachability assessment tip?
Yes, exactly. In fact, that is the only aspect of assessing a coachability aspect. Okay. And of course, in the live demo, I can demonstrate, but just as a summary, right? In our conversation of the coachability assessment, we would be trying to figure out, is the leader who wants to be coached, can he be high on courage, humility, and discipline in his or her journey? Right? Okay. Is he or she willing to go through that? In fact, we will give them an opportunity to, for them to recognize their own leaders whom they admire, right? Whom they really look up to in their professional life, in their personal life, and also recognize their behaviors
okay.
of being high on courage, humility, and discipline. Okay. And first thing would be, are they willing to go through the journey, right? And then based on the conversation and how they respond, we will give them feedback. So when we say coachability assessment, we're not branding a person, you're coachable, not coachable. All we are saying is you're not ready yet because this journey is going to be tougher, right?
Okay.
And if you're not ready, probably we should give feedback so the person becomes mentally ready.
Okay.
That's what it means.
Okay. Okay. So what does the participants of this workshop get during the workshop? What is that they are going to get?
Right. So like I mentioned, right, the real aspect of coaching, if you really consider a coaching journey, right, it's very deep. It's a personal conversation that happens between the coach and the person being coached. So in the entire journey, probably a coach's role is just about 15 to 20%, maybe maximum 25%. Remaining 75% is by the person who needs to be on the job. Right, and really take a lot of actions. So in that context, the success of a real coaching journey depends on a good beginning, right? In qualifying the readiness and then helping the leaders determine the right areas of growth, which matter to them, and then putting them to an action plan, which can happen in a structured manner, right? So from this context, what participants would take away as probably key benefits, and this is definitely useful for those who want to coach leaders, or who want to be coached as a leader. It could be even useful for the leaders who want to be coached so that they can be successful in their journey. So the two key takeaways I would like to highlight. One is, how do you really assess the coachability aspect or coaching readiness aspect of a leader? So that's one thing, one first takeaway. And the second takeaway is, most of the times leaders would be confused about, you know, where they want to head towards, how they want to head towards. So yeah. How do we narrow that discussion so that they can potentially identify top one or two, I would say, development area or growth area, which is important to them, which matters to them, so that they are committed to it, right? How do you do that? These are the two aspects I will be demonstrating. And if you can do this, rest of the journey is almost smoother, and, you know, rest of the coaching is more about your soft skills on, you know, really being that wall which using which leaders can bounce their experience, bounce themselves with their expression, and then you can just support them in the journey.
Okay. Right?
So that's what would be the two takeaways.
So say if I, as a participant, come and attend this workshop, can I use the same tool to assess whether I am ready for a coaching?
Oh, yeah, sure. Definitely. In fact, just to enable that, towards the end of the workshop, because it was a 90-minute workshop, I also designed whatever they observe in the live demonstration with some volunteers. Of course, those who volunteer will get more experience. But just to enable the rest of the people who cannot volunteer, about last 15 to 20 minutes, they get to practice among their peers then and there itself, whatever they just watch. So, and they can go in turns. For first time, they can be a coach, and the other person can be coachy, and the third person can be observer to give feedback, and they can change their roles. So a participant who could not volunteer can actually practice coaching with a peer, both as a coach as well as a person being coached. So they get a taste of it. And this whole process sounds very simple, but the reality is that you need to understand the depth of what it takes to coach. And once they feel that, once they get a feeler about what it means, they can continue to go back and practice in their office or
their office. In the
profession. Like, yeah.
Okay. So you had done many one-on-one coaching, and actually you are working as a transformation coach for Siemens also, right?
Yeah.
In your experience, what are some of myths that we have when it comes to coaching? Give some a feeler so that we can get to know what exactly we are getting into.
Right. I think the I would like to probably call out top two myths in the coaching aspect. The first myth is that coaching is about changing a person, right? Mm-hmm. And that's a myth, because you can never change any person. You know, unless the person wants to change himself or herself, which is also very difficult in reality. Mm-hmm. When they say they want to change, it's probably about they're speaking about changing their behaviors so that they can work well with their colleagues, with their peers, and things like that. So changing behavior also is only when a person wants to change his or her behavior. As a coach, you can help them do that. You can never change any person, right?
Okay.
So that's the number one myth.
Yeah.
And the second myth is that we can coach a person by solving some problem for them, right? Or, you know, by taking away their biggest pain point or blocker, we feel like we are coaching, which is actually not true. Because the more you try to do it yourself as a coach, then it doesn't become the person being coached, right? Mm-hmm. It doesn't become his or her commitment, his or her journey. And, you know, you can always give them this fishes to help them with all the good intention, but it is not going to help them. So you're probably better off to help them learn fishing for themselves. And especially for leaders, it will be a very, very painful journey, because there are too many stakeholders and there's a lot of things at stake. So, and it's going to be uncomfortable. So your coach, your much more value addition would be, how can you help them realize their results by allowing them to do what they need to do, but probably supporting in that journey, right? So the second myth is about, you know, coaching can happen by solving the problem, which is not going to help, which is a myth again.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah. When I experience myself, yes, that stays for a long time. That's true. Yeah. So we covered a little bit about the myth and also what our attendees are going to get it, are the participants getting it. Is there anything else you want to give it to us that makes this session exciting?
Sure. So because, you know, as I understand, this is our the very famous Scrum, regional Scrum gathering. And of course, the context of the participants would be from the software companies, or most probably at least from the IT area. And also most of them would be coming from the agile background. So although this topic can be related to even non-agile, I will try and give a lot more contextual examples on agile transformation, agile space, and how do we coach leaders who needs to undergo transformation for themselves, as well as drive and lead the transformation in the agile space. Right, so I will be sharing such examples, and also some bit of maybe in the Q&A section, I would also talk about what does it take to enable an organizational transformation through coaching, right? And coaching everyone, but especially on the leaders. What is the importance of not preaching, not teaching, but coaching the leaders involved in the transformation? Right, I'll be sharing some experience from my recent transformation.
Okay, so it looks like it's a end-to-end package. It's from leader changing them, the organization, and also having a coaching experience. It looks very exciting. It looks very exciting, sure. And we would like to have this session at full fast and get more value out of it. Yeah,
sure.
Thanks.
Sure.
Thanks, JP, on giving a more insight on what's coming. Yeah?
Sure.
Thank you.
Thanks, Albert. Thanks for this opportunity.
Yes.
Yeah?
Thank you.
See you on the conference day.
Yes, please. Yeah. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.